No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Agnes Williams of Agnes Williams Ministries, Kingdom Connections, here to converse with you once again on principles enshrined in the Word of God so that mankind can become perfect, move to perfection, work to perfection to please Almighty God. Let's pray. Almighty God, I thank you today for another opportunity to be able to share what you have laid upon my heart with your people. The hearts that listen, open their eyes and their ears and their understanding, that each one who hears this word will grow closer to you and their lives will be changed day by day, bit by bit, to be more like Jesus Christ and what you expect of us in your word. Thank you, God. Holy Spirit, take complete control and do the work as usual. Continue to work in men's lives that God will be glorified. Amen. Today I want to just deal in a small topic, small as it may be, that some Christians don't seem to be fully aware that they are sinning when they do this sort of action. And it's lying, liars and lying. My main scripture is taken from Colossians 3, chapter 9. Colossians 3, chapter 9 says, "Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds." Even in Leviticus 19, chapter verse 11, it speaks there also about lying. Leviticus chapter 19 verse 11 says, "You shall not steal, neither deal falsely, neither lie one to another." So God's standard about lies and liars has not changed, the same in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. There's one section of scripture that says, "Lying tongues are an abomination to the Lord." An abomination is a great sin, something that God detests. So it's an abomination. It's very, very serious with God, lying. And many Christians I've come across and in my dealings over the years, many believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, they have repented of their sins. They've accepted Christ as their Savior. They've been water baptized. They're filled with the Holy Spirit. They speak in tongues. But they see nothing wrong in telling a lie to their fellow Christians, to their husbands, to their wives, to their children, to other people. And I want to exhort you today as believers. Sometimes somebody asks you a question, and you don't want to answer. Don't lie. Just stay silent and let the person make his or her own judgment. You didn't admit, you did not refuse, you just ignore the question as though it never existed, as though you never heard it, and move on to another conversation. That should give that person some sort of answer. But we ought to avoid the lying. God says we should not lie one to another. Telling lies at times when we don't speak the truth, or we speak half-truth. A half-truth is a half-lie, so it's still a lie. You can't have half of a head and the other half is not there. You can't have half of a finger and the other half isn't. It's not a total finger. So we ought to learn and practice in our daily life. Even the older believers, I found older believers quick to tell you a lie. And you discern that they are lying to you, but sometimes you don't even want to embarrass them because of the present situation. But each one of us who hear this word today, we should check our lives, check our conversations, check our actions, check the things we do, and try to eliminate telling lies, telling untruth, telling falsehood, deviating from the truth, trying to fool people as much as possible in our daily lives. And once we practice that each day of our life, there'll come a time when lying will not be a part of you. When you keep doing the same thing over and over and over again, repetition, after a while it becomes a part of you. So if we practice not lying, not responding to lies, you listen, you just don't answer. Sometimes you may refute, but let us cease telling lies. Let us cease telling untruths to one another and to ourselves. God is not pleased. It might seem to you as a lie is a small sin, but God says that all liars in his word shall have their part in the lake that burneth with fire and brimstone. So don't think that you tell a little lie and somebody murder a man, and your sin in the eyes of God of lying is less than the sin of murder. S-I-N is S-I-N in the sight of God, in God's agenda, in God's ruling, in God's plan. So we ought to try to avoid as much as possible lying one to another and lying to ourselves. Sometimes the truth is hard to bear or to face up to, but just shut your mouth and don't say anything. Be quiet. We learned as children with our mother, when she asked us if we did something, and she always told us, don't lie to me. And sometimes we won't answer, we'll start to cry. And when you start to cry, our mother knew, yes, you did so and so. And then she'll say, okay, don't do it again. And she'll scold you. She wouldn't even give you a few licks. She'll scold you and she'll send you away. And you learned that lesson so well that after that, you felt so embarrassed and ashamed that you would try not to lie to her or not to do the same thing again. So our mother taught us that. She said, if you can't tell the truth, shut your mouth. Don't answer. And your non-answer gives the answer to the person. Sometimes you may be approved, you may be accused in a wrongful way, and you still choose not to answer. You bear the burden of it, but God knows the truth. And Christians today ought to stop lying. They are petty lies we tell each other. Did you see Sister James yesterday? No, I didn't see her. And then you mumble, I must tell you I saw Sister James. You don't have to lie, just don't respond. I practice non-response with many people. Sometimes they ask me the same question twice and I just don't answer. I take a dose of dumb. I don't shrug my face or my shoulder. I just keep quiet. And they move on to the other question or to the other issues. Christians, believers, we who name the name of Christ, we must do all in our ability, all in our strength to cease lying. When we lie to our children and for our children, they think that lying is a good way of life. And parents who tell lies for their children to other people when their children do wrong, they are sowing a very bad seed in those children's lives. You will grow up and the children will start to tell lies to those parents and they will never admit the truth. That's a very bad foundation to build in a child's life. If a child does something wrong in the neighbor's house, let the child admit that he or she did something wrong. The neighbor would understand. They said, okay, don't do it again. That is not to be done. But when you lie for the child and the child knows that you are telling lies and you are standing up as a parent with them and telling lies, oh, you're sowing a very, very, very dangerous seed in your children's lives. When they become adults, they will continue lying. They can go to jail for lying. People wouldn't trust them They wouldn't tell them, I don't trust you. But they remember things that they did, and they didn't own up to it, and they will, people will, you would not be trustworthy. There are some people in the world who tell me, we trust you. I said, you trust me? They said, yes, because you've done certain things, and we've tried you, and we know you wouldn't do so and so. And I said, oh my God, what an awesome responsibility is when people say they trust you and they believe you. It puts a fear in me. Oh God, help me not to lie. Or if I don't want to speak the truth, shut my mouth. Don't answer as our mother taught us. So parents out there, please do not lie for your children. Let your children grow up knowing that they must admit and take responsibility for whatever they do. So when you sow those good seeds in their lives, as they got older, they get older, they would not be prone to be compulsive liars. They'll go on the job, they'll go to school, and the people know that they are lying. And they grow up around people who don't trust them, who don't trust their word, who wouldn't trust them anywhere, in anything. Folks wouldn't say that, but in their heart they say, I can't trust that child. I can't trust that adult. Because the first thing they do is tell a lie to cover their tracks. And God is, and in all of this scenario, God is seeing and hearing. And if he says in his words that lies, that we should not lie one to another, 1 Colossians chapter 3 verse 9, lie not one to another. See that you have put off the old man, that is Satan, the enemy, with his deeds. Verse 10 said, and we have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created the new man. So, lying tongues are a sin, a great sin, an abomination in the sight of God. And I want to encourage older Christians. Sometimes they'll tell you a lie and say, let him hold that, let her hold that. And then they move on as though nothing has happened. So I want to awaken your conscience today. Telling lies is not godly. Telling lies is sinful. Telling lies does not please God. A liar is as worse as a murderer or a thief. Don't tell lies. There's something that says you plead the Fifth Amendment, you don't answer. And then they'll have to say, well, I guess he or she's guilty. But we must not practice to lie one to another. The Word of God says that. Lie not one to another. Do not tell lies one to another. Even the Old Testament, it says, you shall not lie one to another in Leviticus 19:10. Do not lie one to another. When you lie one to another, you displease God, you are committing sin. Leviticus 19, chapter 9, verse 11 says, you shall not steal, neither deal falsely, neither lie to one another. So from the beginning of time, God has categorized a liar as a sinner. Lying is contrary to God's law. No matter how simple you may think it is, and you think you're fooling somebody, you are committing a sin and you need to repent of lying. Those of us who are believers and who are consistent, compulsive liars, we need to check our lives. Go before God and pray. Ask him to show you where you tell lies all the time. The other people around you, they know you tell lies. Yet you say you're a believer, and you're a Christian. And they know you tell lies deliberately. You swear to all God, and then you're lying. How can they believe your word when you say that you're a child of God? Yes, you're a child of God, but you're an erring child of God. You're a child of God who likes to tell lies. We must cease telling lies to our bosses, our parents, our children, our husbands, our wives, to the merchant, to the man in the street, to our brethren, lying tongues are an abomination to the Lord. And God does not take delight in people who tell lies. As far as God is concerned, a liar is committing a sin. A liar is a sinner. And that is a sin of which we need to repent every day. It isn't hard to do. If you practice day by day, I will not go and tell a lie, because God says lying is a sin. You will check yourself. And at the end of 1 month, you'll be surprised how changed you shall be in the sight of God, in the sight of men, and in your own conscience. And based on the word of God, the Holy Spirit will say, yes, this brother, this sister, this child is trying at least to live in the principles enshrined in the word of God. You lie. Did you see John James passing? No, I didn't see him. But John James passed, and he told you, if Mary asks me if I passed, say you didn't see me. I would not even answer the question. They'll ask me 3-4 times, and I will do like if I didn't hear, I wouldn't answer the question. I wouldn't even say I can't answer. Just don't answer. Nobody can beat you or kill you for not answering a question. So, instead of telling lies, our speech must always be with grace, seasoned with salt, and we must know how to answer every man and a woman. We lie in so many ways. Check your life each day. You lie about the salary you get. You lie about what somebody told you. You lie about picking somebody's food. Brothers and sisters lie on each other. We tell lies to save our good faces, but we should not do that. That is not godly behavior in the sight of God. And if God comes and we die lying, or Christ should come and rapture and we're caught lying, I don't see us seeing God's face. We'll go into the lake that burn with fire and brimstone away from God. Because a little lie, a little spot, contaminates the whole spirit, the whole man. A little blot of ink can contaminate an entire white, pure linen tablecloth. The tablecloth is damaged. That dress is damaged. That shirt is damaged because there's a spot of ink or black or white in it, or red or green. So let's try in very simple ways every day to change our sinful attitudes. Yes, we are believers. Yes, we have been bought by the blood of Jesus Christ. But it says, let every man who named the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Iniquity is constantly doing the same thing over and over. And just as I preach to you, it's the same way I have to practice in my life daily. Did I tell a lie here? Oh my God, forgive me. Then I tell the person, no, I made a mistake, but I didn't tell you this. Or you make sure the next time you don't do the same thing. It's a serious, 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 serious flaw in our character as Christians. We lie to each other. We tell lies all the time. And we say, let him hold that, let her hold that. And we think that God is pleased. God is not pleased. The Holy Spirit is grieved. We ought to be as truthful to the best of our ability. And if we cannot tell the truth, don't say anything. So, you Christians out there, my fellow brethren out there, who lie. You make lying a daily habit. You lie to your boss. You lie to the taxi driver. You lie to your husband. You lie to your wife. You lie to your children. You lie to your friends. You want to look good in the eyes of your friends, and you have a story to tell them, and you add on some parts to it that are not truthful. Instead of saying the story just as it happened, you embellish it and you dress it up with lies to make yourself look good, to make your story look better. And God says, look at him, look at her. he or she is deliberately telling a lie. Let's purge ourselves from lying tongues. Let's purge ourselves from lying habits. Let's purge ourselves from telling lies to each other. As I said, before you lie, shut your mouth. Keep silent. Do not respond. Do not answer. Practice not lying. And if you practice this for a whole year, after a while you'll understand what God says by lying tongues, an abomination, because then you would have been practicing not to lie, and you have been getting closer to God, and you've been able to understand more the things of God. And God, please, please, when mankind tries to live by the principles enshrined in the Word of God, we are all a work in progress, a work in process. We have not been finished processing, being processed, but each day of our lives, God gives another chance to live again. As long as we have breath, we have another chance to live again, not to tell a lie. Tell a lie to your brother, to your sister. Sometimes my children, parents ask them, I had a $5 in my purse. Did you take it? No, mom, no, dad. And the child took it. Where did the child learn that? Either from the parents or from the friends in school, from others. But the child feels that if he or she can tell a lie, they will not be charged and they will not be held accountable. And when they tell a lie, in the eyes of God, they are even more accountable. And the enemy for our soul, Satan, say, yes, I've gotten him or her. And so you continue lying and lying, and your lies become more compounded. And you lie until suddenly one day, people don't believe in you. They don't trust you. And they won't tell you. They'll tell others. They'll say, I don't trust him. I don't trust her. Lie too much. They're strangers to the truth. Don't be called a stranger to the truth. You're a child of God. You have been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. You have been redeemed. People out there, mother, father, auntie, sister, brother, uncle, grandmother, grandfather, friend, let's all check our lives and be a good example to our children, the younger ones growing up. Sometimes we see the generation so terrible, and we fail to realize that we, the adults, are the ones who do things that make them behave how they behave. We lie to them. They hear us telling lies on our neighbors, lies to our neighbors, lies on our friends, lies to our friends, lies on one another. And they say, it's okay for us to steal and kill and destroy. They have no trust in the generation that is. Let your children and the people of you start to put trust in you again. Make a concerted effort to cease telling lies. A lie is an untruth. And a half-truth is a lie. Half-truth is a lie. A half an orange is still an orange. A half an apple is still an apple. So a half-lie is still a lie. But a half-truth is not fully truth. So today, this is a very simple message to us that says, lie not one to another. See that you have put off the old man with his deeds, that is Satan and his deeds. And lying tongues are an abomination to the Lord. And we are admonished not to tell lies one to another. God's word has not changed from the olden days. Now it's the same thing yesterday, today, forever. So if we start with dealing with the lies that we tell, we will have been working out our salvation with fear and trembling. We'll be better Christians, we'll be better believers, better human beings. People can trust us, God can trust us if we cease lying. So I want to exhort you. You don't have to go and tell anybody you're lying if it's not warranted. You just make up in your mind, from today, I will make a concerted effort, a great effort, to cease telling lies in all aspects of my life. And one day at a time, one sentence at a time, one moment at a time, continually doing that, you'll become a person who abhors lies. You would hate telling lies. And you will tell others, and you will feel the difference in your life, in your spiritual life, in your physical life, in your emotional life. You will feel the difference. It does make a difference in your life when you choose to work according to the principles enshrined in the Word of God. So today I leave you with this. Lie not one to another, seeing that you have put off the old man with all his deeds, and lying tongues are an abomination to the Lord. I am Pastor Agnes Williams, thanking you for listening, and I want you to put into action what I've encouraged you to do based on the Word of God. And what I tell you to do, it's the same thing I have to continue doing day after day to ensure that I'm not lying to someone. As I said to you, if I don't want to answer, I don't answer. Have a great day. God bless you. God loves you. And the blood of Jesus Christ will never lose its power till all the ransomed church of God are saved to sin no more.
No weapon.